Good evening. Welcome to Jeevan's News at 8. I'm Durga Prasad. First, let's look at the top stories of the day. Will not implement Charge Act, says Chief Minister. State government against privatization of Thiruvananthapuram Airport in High Court. Seizing will not take place in farmers' lawn. Surface law will not be implemented in lawns for 1 year, says Bangor's committee. High Court against flash hartal. Disregarding constitutional rights cannot be accepted. Notice must be given before any hartal. Ayodhya case, mediation rejected by Hindu Mahasabha in Supreme Court. Muslim bodies in support. Verdict to be heard later. Rafael aircraft case, papers relied on by petitioners marked secret. Supreme Court hearing adjourned to March 14. Now the news in detail. Bangor's union decision brings relief to the farmers. The need to give moratorium for all loans got sanctioned. Agriculture Minister V.S. Sunil Kumar said that the banks accepted the state government's needs. The need of stopping of seizing was sanctioned by the banks. Surfacing will not be imposed on agriculture loans for 1 year, added the minister. Opposition leader Ramesh Chennitala demanded to waive the agriculture loans and boost farmers with confidence.
മഹാരാഷ്ട്രയിൽ നടന്ന സമരത്തിന്റെ മുമ്പിൽ വലിയ കൊടിയുമായി നിന്ന് സമരം നടത്തിയ ആളുകൾക്ക് അഭിവാദ്യം അർപ്പിച്ച തോമസ് ഐസക്ക്, ഇവിടെ എന്തുകൊണ്ട് നിങ്ങൾ ആ കർഷകർക്ക് വേണ്ടി നിയമസഭാ സമ്മേളനം വിളിച്ചു കൂട്ടുന്നില്ല? എന്തുകൊണ്ട് നിങ്ങൾ അവരുടെ കടം എഴുതി തള്ളുന്നില്ല? ഞാനിപ്പം എഴുതി തള്ളണമെന്ന് നമ്മൾ ആവശ്യപ്പെട്ട് ഞാൻ ഒരു കരുതി ഇവരാ പലിശയെങ്കിലും ഒന്ന് എഴുതി തള്ളുമെന്ന്, അത്രയെങ്കിലും പലിശയെങ്കിലും ഒന്ന് എഴുതി തള്ളാം, അതും ചെയ്തില്ല. ഇപ്പൊ പറയുന്നുണ്ട് ആ കടാശ്വാസ കമ്മീഷൻ, ആളുകൾ ചിരിക്കുകയാണ് ഈ കടാശ്വാസ കമ്മീഷന്റെ കാര്യം പറഞ്ഞു. ഈ കടാശ്വാസ കമ്മീഷൻ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് തന്നെ ഒരു ഒരു വലിയ ബാധ്യതയാണ്. കാരണം ഇതോ ഇതിന്റെ നടപടിക്രമങ്ങളൊക്കെ വരുമ്പോഴത്തേക്ക് ഇനി എത്ര പേര് ആത്മഹത്യ എന്ന് ആർക്കറിയാം. ഇതിൽ നിന്നും ഇതൊക്കെ വളരെയേറെ നൂലാമാലകളും നിയമങ്ങളും നോംസുകളും ഉള്ള കാര്യങ്ങളാണ്. പിഴ പലിശ പോലും എഴുതി തള്ളാൻ കഴിയാത്ത ഒരു ഗവൺമെന്റാണ് കേരളത്തിൽ അധികാരത്തിലുള്ളത്. അതുകൊണ്ട് ഞാൻ അവസാനിപ്പിക്കുന്ന ഒത്തിരി നേരൊക്കെ സംസാരിക്കാറുണ്ട്. വൈകുന്നേരം എനിക്ക് നിങ്ങളോട് ചില കാര്യങ്ങൾ പറയാനുണ്ട്, ഞാൻ അവസാനിപ്പിക്കാറുണ്ട്. കേരളത്തിലെ കർഷകർ ഇന്ന് ആത്മഹത്യാ മുനമ്പിലെത്തി നിൽക്കുന്നു.
ഇൻ കാസർഗോഡ്, ഓൾ സിറ്റിംഗ് MPs എക്സെപ്റ്റ് പി കരുണാകരൻ വിൽ ബി ഇൻ ദ ഇലക്ഷൻ ഫ്രീ. സ്റ്റേറ്റ് കമ്മിറ്റി വിൽ ടേക്ക് എ ഫൈനൽ ഡിസിഷൻ ഓൺ കാൻഡിഡേറ്റ്സ് ഓൺ തേഴ്സ്ഡേ. എ സമ്പത്ത്, MP രാജേഷ്, PK ബിജു ആൻഡ് PK ശ്രീമതി വിൽ കണ്ടസ്റ്റ് ഫോർ ദ തേർഡ് ടൈം. നോ ഡിസിഷൻ ഹാസ് ബീൻ ടേക്കൺ അബൌട്ട് ആക്ട് ഇന്നസെൻസ് കാൻഡിഡേറ്റ്. കൺസിഡറിംഗ് ഹിസ് ഹെൽത്ത് സ്റ്റാറ്റസ്, ദ ഡിസിഷൻ ഹാസ് ബീൻ ലെഫ്റ്റ് ടു ഹിം. പി സതീദേവി ആൻഡ് മുഹമ്മദ് റിയാസ് ആർ ബീങ് കൺസിഡർ ഫോർ വടകര കോൺസ്റ്റിറ്റ്യുവൻസി. VP Sanu, an independent candidate, is being considered for Ponnani and Malappuram constituencies. KB Satish Chandra is likely to contest from Kasaragod. Janata Dal S may not get a seat this time. Their cotton seat will be taken over by the CPM. CPM will contest in 16 seats and CPI in 4 seats. UDF is hoping to win in Kannur constituency in the upcoming Lok Sabha elections. K. Sudhakaran will probably be the UDF candidate. CPM believes that PK Srimathi is highly popular in the constituency. Srimathi had won with a majority of 6,566 votes in the previous elections. Party hopes that her majority will increase this year. The assemblies of Chief Minister Pinrai Vijayan, Ministers E.P. Jayarajan and Ramachandran are in this constituency. CPM has a majority of more than 40,000 votes in these assemblies. This gives more hope for the party. Meantime, UDF also hopes to win back the constituency by fielding K. Sudhakaran. UDF hopes that Shabirimala issue and Periya murders will be helpful for the party in the constituency. News Desk, Jeevan. The Kerala High Court said that everyone was bound by its earlier ban on impromptu hartals while rejecting the defense of Youth Congress State President Dean Kuriakose and United Democratic Front Kasaragod District Convener Kamaruddin that they were not aware of the judgment.
The opposition leaders were pulled up by the court for an impromptu shutdown called for by their outfit to protest the murder of two of its members, Sharat Lal and Krupesh in Periya in Kasaragod. Kuriakose and Kamruddin maintained that they were not party to the original case. That led to the court to rule that any organization that called for a hartal should do so only after issuing prior notices. Issuing a notice, however, is not licensed to indulge in violence, the court added. Kuriakose said that he was not responsible for the violent protest as he had only called for peaceful protest. The court will consider whether Kuriakose was in contempt of the court when the case is taken up to March 18th. That would amount to the violation of constitutional rights, the court added. The Kerala High Court had in January ruled that political parties, organizations and individuals who called for hartals were bound to give 7 days prior notice. The court made the comment while hearing a petition moved by the Kerala Chamber of Commerce and Industry and Thrissur-based NGO Malayala Vedi against shutdowns in the state. The court further said that organizations and individuals who call for hartal shall be responsible for loss and damages caused on account of the shutdown. News desk, Jeevan.
The Met Department has said that the increase in temperature will continue across the state for 3 days. Temperature will rise to 38 degrees in several places. People will have to be alert for 3 days.
Highest temperature was recorded in Palakkad on Tuesday, 37.4 degree. Temperature in Thiruvananthapuram, Alappuzha and Kozhikode district rose by 2 to 2.3 degrees than normal temperature. Increased temperature might be experienced in some parts of Ernakulam, Kottayam, Idukki, Pathanamthitta, Kollam and Thiruvananthapuram districts. Temperature is likely to rise to 38 degree in Kozhikode till March 9. Officials have warned high temperature in Alappuzha and Punaluru too. The State Disaster Management Authority has said that heat wave is unlikely to continue in the district on Wednesday and Thursday. Temperature rose by only 2.1 degrees on Tuesday. The possibility of heat wave is when the average temperature rises by 4.5 degrees. The heat wave alert issued by Thiruvananthapuram Met Department was withdrawn by Tuesday afternoon. At the same time, the Disaster Management Authority has warned on rising temperature during daytime. People have been advised to obey the instructions given by the state government. As there are no chances of rain in the coming days, temperature will continue to rise. A meeting was held in the collectorate to discuss about the precautions to face drought. Brochures will be distributed at homes to make them aware of saving drinking water. Water kiosks will be set up to ensure availability of drinking water. Driving tests will not be held in the district between 11 a.m. 3 p.m. considering the alert issued on heat wave. Minister A.K. Shashindran has given the instruction considering the special situation in northern Kerala. The driving test will begin at 7 a.m. The test should be completed before 11 itself. The remaining test can be conducted after 3 p.m. Usually tests are held at 9 a.m. It has been instructed to continue the new time schedule until the alert for heat wave is withdrawn. News desk, Jeevan.
The Kerala government's efforts to project the state as investor-friendly has suffered a major setback with technocrats, heads of global firms and representatives of IT and trade bodies coming out in the open flaying the CPN-led government's stand against privatizing the Thiruvananthapuram International Airport.
The Kerala government's decision to move court challenging the tendering by Airports Authority of India for selecting the private party for management, operation and development of Kerala. The major concern of the industry bodies is that Thiruvananthapuram Airport, which has been managed by the Airports Authority of India, is losing out to other airports with regard to connectivity and infrastructure. There are even unconfirmed reports that a major IT company that recently started operations in Thiruvananthapuram is even weighing options of relocating owing to poor air connectivity to other Indian cities. The Kerala State Industrial Development Corporation, a Kerala government undertaking that unsuccessfully participated in the tendering for the airport, has moved court against handing over the airport to the Adani Group, which won the bid. Meanwhile, Kerala Chief Minister's Private Secretary M.V. Jayarajan told that the Kerala government's stand was being misinterpreted as an anti-private investment. He said that the Kerala government was trying for public-private participation model airport, as in the case of the Cochin International Airport Limited in Kochi and the Kannur International Airport Limited that are proving to be successful. This would give opportunity to more private parties, including major IT companies in the state, to invest in the airport's development, he said. Jeevan News, Thiruvananthapuram.
The government today told the Supreme Court that documents related to a Rafael aircraft deal have been stolen from the Defence Ministry and the petitioner seeking a review of its verdict, dismissing all pleas against the purchase of the jets, relied upon those documents.
A three-judge bench comprising Chief Justice Ranjan Gogoi and Justices S.K. Kaul and K.M. Joseph began the open court hearing, during which former Union Ministers Yashwant Sinha and Arun Shauri and Advocate Prashant Bhushan, who had jointly filed a petition, alleged that the centre suppressed crucial facts when the Apex Court decided to dismiss the batch of public interest litigations against the Rafael deal in December. When Bhushan referred to an article written by senior journalist N. Ram in the Hindu newspaper, Attorney General K.K. Venugopal opposed it, saying his write-ups were based on stolen documents and an investigation into the theft is on. Advancing his arguments on behalf of Sinha, Shauri and himself, Bhushan said critical facts on Rafael were supposed when the petition for an FIR and investigation were filed. He said the top court would not have dismissed the plea for FIR and probe into Rafael deal had there not been suppression of facts. Venugopal said the documents relied upon by Bhushan were stolen from the Defence Ministry and an investigation into the matter was underway. The AG also submitted that the documents on the deal relied on by the petitioners were marked secret and classified and therefore are in violation of Official Secrets Act. The bench rose for the lunch break, asking Venugopal to apprise it about the whole development related to the stealing of the documents and the investigation conducted by the centre in the post-lunch session. National Desk, Jeevan. The Supreme Court today reserved its order on whether the politically sensitive Ram Janmabhoomi Babri Masjid land dispute can be settled through mediation.
A five-judge constitution bench headed by Chief Justice Ranjan Gogoi heard the contesting parties. The bench, also comprising Justices S.A. Bobre, D.Y. Chandrachud, Ashok Bhushan and S.A. Nazir, heard submissions from various Hindu and Muslim bodies involved in the matter. 14 appeals have been filed in the Apex Court against the 2010 Allahabad High Court judgment delivered in four civil suits that 2.77-acre land in Ayodhya be partitioned equally among the three parties, the Sunni Waqf Board and Nirmohi Akhara and Ram Lalla. National Desk, Jeevan.
West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee attacked the Narendra Modi government for allegedly spoliticizing the sacrifice of Jawans and said that she strongly condemned those who play politics with martyrs. The Trinamool Congress chief said, "You cannot win elections over Jawan's blood," and added that a Jawan sheds his blood for the nation.
Slamming the ruling party at the centre, the West Bengal CM said, "You cannot win elections over Jawan's blood. A Jawan sheds his blood for the country. They serve the country. They do not indulge in politics. I strongly condemn those who play politics with the martyrs." She also questioned the government over the Pulwama attack, calling it an intelligence failure and said, "Who give this intelligence reports?" In an all-out attack against PM Modi, she accused the Prime Minister of turning BJP into a private organization. "We are against Modi and BJP. Modi has turned the BJP into a private organization. Whenever someone says something against Modi Babu, then that person is branded a Pakistan supporter." The TMC chief further said, "My father was a freedom fighter. I will not learn patriotism from them."
আজকে মোদি প্রাইভেট কোম্পানি, মোদি অফিসার প্রাইভেট কোম্পানি করে দিয়েছে। আজকে বিজেপি পার্টিটাকে পর্যন্ত বিজেপি পার্টির কারো কোনো মূল্য নেই, টোটালটাই মূল্য লেস হয়ে গেছে। আর আজকে সবাইকে ভয় দেখিয়ে, সবাইকে চোখ রাঙিয়ে, আর যেই ওদের বিরুদ্ধে সমালোচনা করছে তাকে পাকিস্তানি করে দেওয়া হচ্ছে, তাকে দেশের তৈরি করে দেওয়া হচ্ছে। আমি পরিষ্কার বলি, আমরা হিন্দুস্তানি, এটা আমাদের গর্ব, আমরা ভারতবর্ষের মানুষ, এটা আমাদের গর্ব, বাংলার মাটিতে আমি জন্মগ্রহণ করেছি।
On February 14th, a Jaish-e-Muhammad suicide bomber had rammed an explosive-laden vehicle with a bus plying CRPF Jawans in Jammu and Kashmir's Pulwama, killing at least 40 CRPF Jawans. In retaliation, 12 Myra 2000 of Indian Air Force crossed the line of control on February 26th and bombed a Jaish terror camp in Pakistan's Balakot, killing several terrorists. National Desk, Jeevan.
The High Court of Kerala directed to complete the trial in Kochi actress abduction case in 6 months. High Court gave the direction while rejecting the bail plea of Martin Anthony, the second accused in the case. Martin, in his plea, cited that he has been in the jail for 2.5 years and Dilip, the main accused in the case, had been remanded only for 85 days. In the plea, Martin further added that he always tried to cooperate with the investigation and was taken into custody on February 18, 2017, the next day of the incident. Jeevan Janahidan started in Alappuzha seeking public's opinion on Lok Sabha election. Janahida Yatra will be analyzing in all the constituencies about the subjects that will be discussed in the election.
ജനമനം തേടി ജീവന്റെ ജനഹിതയാത്ര
മധുരാണല്ലോ. അപ്പോ എന്തൊക്കെയാണ് ഇവിടെ ആലപ്പുഴക്കാർക്ക് എന്തൊക്കെയാണ് ഈ മണ്ഡലത്തിലേക്ക് വേണ്ടത്?
അതിനെ കുറിച്ച് പറയാൻ എനിക്ക് അറിഞ്ഞുകൂടാ. കുടിവെള്ളം ഇല്ല, ഭയങ്കര ക്ഷാമം. ഒന്നര വർഷമുള്ള ക്ഷാമം. വെള്ളം പൈപ്പിൽ വെള്ളം ഇപ്പോഴും വെള്ളമില്ല. അതൊക്കെ പറയാം. ഒട്ടും വെള്ളം കിട്ടുന്നില്ല, കുടിക്കാൻ വെള്ളമില്ല. അപ്പൊ വാങ്ങിച്ചെടുക്കുക.
ഇതാണ് ഞാൻ സ്ഥിരം ഇവിടെ കണ്ടുവരുന്നത്, ജില്ലാ കോടതി പാലം. ഈ കോടതിയും പിന്നെ മിനി സിവിൽ സ്റ്റേഷനും അപ്പുറത്തായത് കൊണ്ട് മോട്ടോർ വാഹനക്കാർക്കും യാത്രക്കാർക്കും ഭയങ്കര ബുദ്ധിമുട്ടാണ് ഉണ്ടാക്കുന്നത്.
തെരഞ്ഞെടുപ്പ് മാനിഫെസ്റ്റോ പാലിച്ചില്ലെങ്കിൽ അത് തെരഞ്ഞെടുപ്പ് ചട്ട ലംഘനമായി കണക്കാക്കേണ്ടതല്ലേ?
അത് കുറേ എല്ലാം നടപ്പാക്കുന്നുണ്ട്, കുറച്ചൊക്കെ നടക്കാണ്ടും പോകുന്നുണ്ട്.
ജനങ്ങൾ ഇപ്പോൾ കേന്ദ്രത്തിൽ ആര് വരണം എന്നാണ് ആഗ്രഹം?
ചിലർ ബി ജെ പി വരുന്ന ആഗ്രഹം, ചിലർ കോൺഗ്രസ് വരുന്ന ആഗ്രഹിക്കുന്നവരുണ്ട്.
എങ്ങനെയുണ്ട് ഇപ്പം നരേന്ദ്ര മോദി സർക്കാരിൻ്റെ ഭരണം? എങ്ങനെ
എൻ്റെ പേര് നിയാസ്, ഞാൻ ഹൗസ്ബോട്ടിൻ്റെ ഓണറാണ്.
ആലപ്പുഴ
പിന്നെ നമുക്ക് ഒരു ടൂറിസം ഒരു ഗസ്റ്റ് വന്നു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഇപ്പോൾ വന്ന് ഗസ്റ്റിന് വരാൻ ബുദ്ധിമുട്ടായിട്ട് വരികയും ഇവിടെ ഈ കനാലിൻ്റെ പ്രശ്നങ്ങൾ ഒരുപാടുണ്ട്. അതായത് ഈ ഗസ്റ്റ് വന്നു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഈ ഇതിൻ്റെ തോട്ടിലെ സ്മെല്ലുകളും അത് ഗസ്റ്റിൽ നിന്ന് പോകാൻ ബുദ്ധിമുട്ടുള്ള കാര്യങ്ങളും ഒരുപാട് കാര്യങ്ങൾ മുന്നോട്ട് വരും.
US President Donald Trump has said that he intends to end the preferential trade status granted to India and Turkey, asserting that New Delhi has failed to assure America of equitable and reasonable access to its markets, an announcement that could be seen as a major setback to bilateral trade ties.
President Trump notified Congress in letters of his intent to terminate trade benefits for both countries under the generalized system of preferences eligibility criteria. Under the United States GSP program, nearly 2,000 products, including auto components and textile materials, can enter the U.S. duty-free if the beneficiary developing countries meet the eligibility criteria established by Congress. India was the largest beneficiary of the program in 2017, with the U.S. dollars $5.7 billion in imports to the U.S. given duty-free status, and Turkey the fifth largest with US dollars $1.7 billion in covered imports, according to a Congressional Research Service report issued in January. In a letter to Speaker of the US House of Representatives Nancy Pelosi, Trump said he was determined that New Delhi had not assured the US that it would provide equitable and reasonable access to the markets of India. Trump, who has vowed to reduce US trade deficits, has repeatedly called out India for its high tariffs. Addressing a four-day annual Conservative Political Action Conference in Maryland on Saturday, Trump accused India of being a high-tariff nation and threatened to impose a reciprocal tax to match the heavy duties that New Delhi imposes on goods imported from the United States. The GSP criteria include, among others, respecting arbitral awards in favor of U.S. citizens or corporations, combating child labor, respecting internationally recognized worker rights, providing adequate and effective intellectual property protection, and providing the U.S. with equitable and reasonable market access. Countries can also be graduated from the GSP program, depending on factors related to economic development. In a separate letter, Trump also informed the Congress of his intent to terminate the GSP beneficiary designation of Turkey. He said it was primarily because the economy of Turkey had improved a lot in the last 4.5 decades. In the 4.5 decades since Turkey's designation as a GSP beneficiary developing country, Turkey's economy has grown and diversified, he added. International Desk, Jeevan.
Over to sports. Ajax produced a performance for the ages at the Santiago Bernabeu to overturn their first leg deficit and knock out Real Madrid. Goals from Hakim Ziyech and David Neres turned the Tyones' head inside 18 minutes, with Duane Tadic, who had assisted both first-half efforts sensationally so far for the second, adding a thumping third just past the hour to leave Madrid with a mountain to climb. Marco Asensio strike the hostess, who had also hit the woodwork through Rafael Varane and Gareth Bale, brief hope only for last to quickly curl and direct from a free kick wide on the left. It was a truly remarkable night for Erik ten Hag's side. Ajax had been unfortunate to lose the first leg, and tonight they showed their true value with a courageous and outstanding display. 4 years ago, Real Madrid conceded 4 at home in the last 16, but progressed regardless. This is a far more painful defeat for the holders, though, who had not lost a UEFA Champions League knockout tie since the 2014-2015 semi-finals. Tadic was imperious, setting up two of the goals and scoring a beauty himself. His range of flicks, dribbles and passes must have reminded the home supporters of the great Zidane no less. Always available for the outball, always apparently one step ahead of his opponent, he was unplayable. Sports Desk, Jeevan. India bowled and fielded spectacularly to defend 250 after Virat Kohli's 40th 100 to beat Australia in the second ODI in Nagpur by 8 runs. India now lead the 5-match ODI series 2-0. On Saturday, Kedar Jadhav and MS Dhoni had helped India win the series opener by 6 wickets in Hyderabad. Australia were chasing a tricky target on a tricky pitch, but Aaron Finch and Usman Khawaja were solid after probing spells by Mohammad Shami and Jasprit Bumrah. The Australian openers grew in confidence and the visitors were soon cruising at 83 for no loss before India spinners turned it around. Kuldeep Yadav drew first blood when he trapped Finch LBW for 37 in the 15th over of the innings. Exactly 6 balls later and without a run being added, Kedar Jadhav snared Khawaja as Australia slipped to 83 for 2. Sean Marsh, who had a good ODI series against India down under, was the next to go when he edged a Ravindra Jadeja delivery to MS Dhoni behind the wickets. Glenn Maxwell fell to scoreboard pressure. India spinners had chalked him with a fair few dot balls, and Maxwell played a poor shot to Kuldeep. Australia, after 132 for 4 in the 29th over, suddenly had a huge task at hand. Peter Hanscom, however, was up for it. Along with Marcus Stoinis, Hanscom stitched up a strong partnership before he was run out to a brilliant direct throw from Ravindra Jadeja against the run of play. On a sluggish pitch, it was going to be difficult for a new batsman to settle down quickly. Sports Desk, Jeevan.
Before we wind up, headlines once again. Will not implement Charge Act, says Chief Minister. State government against privatization of Tiruvannamalai Airport in High Court. Seizing will not take place in farmers' lawn. Surplusage law will not be implemented in lawns for 1 year, says Bangor's committee. High Court against flash hartal. Disregarding constitutional rights cannot be accepted. Notice must be given before any hartal. Ayodhya case. Mediation rejected by Hindu Mahasabha in Supreme Court. Muslim bodies in support. Verdict to be heard later. Rafael aircraft case. Papers relied on by petitioners marked secret. Supreme Court hearing adjourned to March 14. That's all today from the English News Desk. Thank you for watching. Good night.